The Hawaiian Islands are the summits of some of the world's largest volcanoes. These volcanoes originated under the sea and erupted in an orderly direction from the northwest to the southeast along undersea cracks in the ocean floor. Millions of years ago, the oceans covered the surface of the Earth. Underneath the ocean floor, hot liquid rock under great pressure moved inside the mantle layer of the Earth. Cracks opened in the floor of the Pacific Ocean at great depths. The liquid rock, or magma, poured out slowly and hardened.
Darkness of the sun, darkness of the night, nothing but night, the night gave birth.
Over a period of about 20 million years, this hardened magma, or lava, built up layer on layer and formed great undersea mountains.
The land disappears into them, covered by the darkness of the night. Still, it is night. The legendary Maui, mischievous son of the goddess Hina, drew these islands from the ocean with the magic fishing hook, Manaiakalani.
The undersea volcanoes finally built up above the surface of the ocean, and the first land surface of the Hawaiian Islands was born amidst clouds of hissing steam. Eruptions continued, and lava flowed from the tops and sides of the volcanoes. Inside, deep, long fissures, or openings, channeled lava out through hundreds of cracks on the sides of the volcanoes. Layers of lava formed huge shield volcanoes whose tops were tall and rounded. The growth of the shield volcanoes was almost finished. Eruptions resulted in the tops caving in because they were heavier than the liquid lava underneath. This formation is called a caldera. As eruptions continued, lava filled in the caldera and overflowed down the slopes of the volcano. The last eruptions were very explosive and threw out showers of liquid rock fragments. A rough lava cap finally covered the caldera. The cap was more uneven and steep than the sides of the volcano. The main stages of volcano activity were completed, and the islands were quiet for a long time. But thousands of years later, minor eruptions occurred and formed small cones on the surface of the old volcanoes.
Pele, goddess of the volcanoes, was born on the floating land of Kuai He Lani. She fled from her angry sister, the sea goddess, Na Makau Kaha'i. In her magic canoe, she sailed to Hawaii with her five brothers and eight sisters. Pele first landed on Ni'ihau. She was seeking a home deep in the earth where she could keep her fires warm and dry. She tunneled into the earth until it burned. But not finding a suitable place, she continued on to Kauai. She would test many places by digging craters with her magic rod, the pawa. Pele plunged the pawa into the ground at Waikanaloa, but water filled the bottom of the flame-fed pit and quenched her fires. Pele next traveled to the island of Oahu. With the pawa, she drilled Diamond Head until it was white with heat, but she was not satisfied. With her family, Pele sailed on to Molokai, then to Lanai, and later to Maui. They they rested in the red glowing rumbling volcano of Haleakala, but it was too large to be kept warm. The spirit of Pele journeyed on to the island of Hawaii. Pele sank her paua deep in the earth at Kilauea on the slopes of Mauna Loa. The magic rod did not touch water. And so the fiery goddess made her home beneath the steaming pit of Kilauea. The goddess Pele tears in a frenzy. She raves and beats about in the pit. Its crumbled walls float like boats.
Lava was the building block of the Hawaiian Islands. There are two types of lava. A'a is the more common type of lava. It is sharp and rough and contains trapped bubbles of gas. An a'a flow moves slowly with a tremendous roar. It looks like a river of tumbling, red-hot rocks. Pahoehoe lava flows quickly like liquid and hardens into ripples and folds. It is hotter than a'a.
How like the flight of a swift canoe is the flow of the Pahoehoe as the mountain melts and rolls away.
Sometimes lava tubes were created when the outside of a Pahoehoe flow cooled and hardened, but the hot lava inside drained out after the eruption ceased. The lava hardened into beautiful and unusual forms, such as volcanic glass. Lava covered trees, leaving hardened molds across the landscape.
I hear the pitiful sob of the trees. The tree gods weep at their change into stone.
Erosion is the process which wears away land. Erosion has sculptured the huge shield volcanoes of Hawaii into mountains, hills, valleys, and plains. Water is the most important element in the process of erosion. Over hundreds of thousands of years, water can wear away even the hardest materials, like rock. Streams fed by heavy rains flowed down the surface of the volcanoes, especially along old channels from lava flows. The streams cut V-shaped gulches on the sides of the volcanoes. Gradually, the streams carved out deep valleys and wide canyons. The amphitheater-headed valley results from a very long period of erosion. It has steep valley walls and a high semicircular head. Rainfall and gravity loosened the rock, soil, and plants on the tops and slopes. Streams carried the loose matter into the valley bottoms. Wide, flat valley floors were gradually built up. Since rainfall is heaviest on the windward side, the mountain slopes on this side of each island are the most worn.
Deep gullied the canyons, toothed are the cliffs. Kamapua'a was a demigod who could take the form of a pig or man. He lived on the windward side of Oahu. When he was a pig, he dug deep in the earth for sweet potatoes. The grooves in the Ko'olau Mountains were made by his snout as he dug.
Ocean waves also wore away the edges of the volcanoes and helped to shape the islands.
Born was rough weather, born the current, born the booming of the sea, the breaking of foam, born the roaring, advancing, and receding of waves.
Waves pounded the base of the shield volcanoes and formed tall cliffs. The miracle of life began on the barren lava flows. Small seeds and spores floated on air and ocean currents to Hawaii. Sometimes they were attached to migrating birds that flew to Hawaii. The A'a lava was a good place for seeds to grow. It was rich in minerals and the cracks held water.
Born was the Ekaha moss living in the sea, guarded by the Ekahakaha fern living on the land. Darkness slips into light. Earth and water are the food of the plant.
Some of the early forms of plant life that grew in Hawaii were lichens, fungi, ferns, and mosses. Soil was first formed by the combination of small rock particles and decaying plants. More plant species arrived in the islands and grew. Larger plants, like the Ohia lehua, provided shade and shelter for smaller plants. The ground cover of the plants and their roots helped to trap water also. Slowly, forests grew and spread.
The plentiful rain has made bright this bud of upland lehua.
Insects and birds were able to survive in the islands because the plants provided them with food and shelter. The insects arrived mostly from Asia and the Southwest Pacific. They traveled on wind currents, ocean currents, and on birds. Land snails also arrived in Hawaii via birds. Migrating birds, capable of flying great distances, also settled in the islands.
Land birds were born, sea birds were born. Born was the noyo, living at sea, guarded by the pueo, living on land.
The family of honeycreepers is unique because they are found only in Hawaii and nowhere else in the world. After arriving in Hawaii, they developed into 22 different species over a long period of time. Very few land-dwelling mammals came to Hawaii on their own. The only ones are the hoary bat and the monk seal. From the mountains to the sea, there was a balance among living things and the land itself. When the first Polynesian voyagers arrived in the Hawaiian Islands, they gazed on a beautiful land which would be their new home.
Man for the narrow stream, woman for the broad stream.